And I'm going to share one car story. So we all pull up there driving. I was fortunate enough to go to hockey school at Bobby Rose Hockey School in Canada when I was 9. And of course I slept through the night, and the next morning my mother said to me, she said, I thought we were flying last night, Michael. She said, Dad was going 110 the whole way.
It's so fitting that we're here in this church where I came to Sunday Mass, growing up with Mom and Dad, alongside Tommy, Colleen, and Michael. This is the church I received First Holy Communion, confirmation, and served as an altar boy. As a family, we weren't the first ones seated for Mass or in the front row. We were usually in the back section right. Sometimes lucky enough to find a pew we could all fit together. Dad had it nailed down to a sign stone. We only lived about a mile away. And if we hit every light, we were there in 90 seconds or less.
My father built his life around helping people. He was born in 1924 to a father who faced a lifelong disability after he was gassed in the trenches during World War I. His mother worked in a shoe factory at age 14, and later on became a labor organizer in the shoe industry in Lynn. During the 1930s, he remembered his mother helping people while working at the WPA, the Work Progress Administration. He learned at an early age that he could make a difference in people's lives. As a 5'6", 112-pound 17-year-old, he joined the Marines as a member of the 4th Division. He participated in 4 major engagements in 1944. In February of 1945, he was part of the invasion of Iwo Jima, one of the bloodiest battles in